Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Namaskaram. Welcome you all to the sixth day, second session of Smaranarpanam, an artistic tribute to Maniyakka, Guru Srimati Nagamani Srinivasarao. I hope you're enjoying our lineup and thank you for your continued support of our 10-day Natya and Sangeetam Festival. We bring to you Bhava Pravaham and Shishyakulam series. In the Bhava Pravaham series, we feature eminent artists, close family members who are all part of the extended Bharata Chudamani and Bharata Darshana families. Today, we have as part of Bhava Pravaham series, Dr. Preeta Sampath from Chennai and Srimati Padmanichari from Houston, Texas. In Shishyakulam series, we feature Natyam across generations. We bring to you a mother and daughter pair, Jyotishmati Swaminathan and Shreyasi Sundaram. We are also excited to bring to you a special choreography of Maniyakka, which was one of her favorites.
Dr. Preeta Sampath is a Bharatanatyam dancer and a senior disciple of Guru Adiyar K. Lakshman. She also learned under the able tutelage of Guru Adiyar K. Ramarao and Guru Srimati Nagmani Srinivasarao. Dr. Preeta Sampath is a dentist by profession.
Namaskaram. Smaranarpanam, an artistic tribute to Maniyakka, our guru and founder of Bharata Darshana, late Srimati Nagamani Srinivasarao. Smaranarpanam is a 10-day global online dance and music festival from 10th October, which marks 1 year since our beloved Maniyakka left for the heavenly abode, to 20th October, which marks Bharata Darshana's 32nd anniversary. Smaranarpanam brings to you 150 plus dancers and musicians from all over the globe. We invite you to witness an exciting lineup of theme-based events, Mani Nritya Malika, Guru Parampara, Shishya Kulam, and Bhava Pravaham. Welcome you to Bhava Pravaham, interview series with family members, artists, and senior students of Maniyakka. Today we have with us an eminent personality in the field of dance. It is my privilege to introduce to you Dr. Preeta Sampath. Dr. Preeta Sampath is a senior Bharatanatyam dancer and has learned this beautiful art form from a very young age from the renowned late Guru Padma Shri, Shri Adiyar K. Lakshman of the Kalakshetra style. She has performed in several major sabhas in India and abroad over the years and has won many laurels and accolades for Bharatanatyam from the Government of India. Yel Isai Nataka Mandram of the state of Tamil Nadu, Madras Doordarshan, Chidambaram Natyanjali Dance Festival, just to name a few. Her most recent performance was to celebrate her Guru's 86th birth anniversary in December 2019 in Chennai in Kalakshetra, which received raving reviews from the press and won the hearts of the audience. She is a dental surgeon by profession and owns a private practice in Chennai. I now request our director, Guru Srimati Saujanya Madhusudan, daughter-in-law of Maniyakka, to host the session. Saujanya ma'am, over to you.
Namaskaram, Mata. Namaskaram, Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.
Shri Gurubhyo. It is an honor to have you with us today as part of Bhava Pravaham series. And thank you for sparing your precious time with us to share your memories and experiences of the moments you spent with Maniyakka and Lakshman sir and the whole family. Akka, what do you remember from your first meeting with Amma Manika?
I started with Lakshman sir extremely early. I must have been about six. I think I had just turned six. I must have been close to six and a half. And I saw him doing Natuvangam for Anita Ratnam and Preeta Ratnam at Sri Krishna Gana Sabha. And my mom had just taken me just to see the performance. And I still vividly remember the items that were done. And I was so I was extremely enticed just by the costumes and the jewelry and the lights and just the whole, you know, performance itself. So then Amma then took me, I was pestering her. I said, I want to learn dance. So then she said, Seri, I'll take you to Lakshman sir himself because you're so, you know, enamored by him. Just before that, both the Ratnam sisters, they took me up to stage and, you know, I saw him and I just fell at his feet. I didn't know what else to do. And he said, and also he was very, you know, he condescended and he asked me. And so I was extremely touched that, you know, somebody, a legend like that, you know, and he was just Tantuangam and, you know, Guru and, you know, they're telling all about him. And he is coming and asking a really little girl like me, you know, how are you, dance kathakriya, all that. Dance on a kinnik evening pidichada, all that he asked. So I was extremely enamored by this, you know, whole, his condescending and just being so gentle, so kind and so compassionate to somebody of my age. Mm-hmm. So then I started pestering these people at home and then they said, Seri, boy, just go join. You're not going to, you know, be quiet otherwise. You know, they basically, you know, put a rest to all my pestering. So then my dad also, all of us in the family have been extremely, you know, art connoisseurs. So, you know, we go to music and dance festivals. And even at 3 and 4, I would go and sit with them, the whole entire performance and all that. So I knew a few ragas here and there. So luckily for me, I recognized a few ragas in the dance recital. And I was, I know all these ragas. And I was very, you know, touched by that whole thing. And then they took me to Bharata Chudamani. It must have been 76, 77, something around that, in and around that. And or a Friday evening, they, you know, Amma took me, you know, with the big tambulam and all that. And then, you know, I fell at his feet, I got. And then he said, then he himself stood up and he taught me how to do namaskaram. So he said, tai ipdi pidichuko, apdi pidichuko, all that, you know, just like he would teach a little baby. That is how he taught me. And after namaskaram, he said, first you have to sit. This is called aramandi. And of course, the first time you're sitting, so your feet were aching in your knees. You couldn't sit. You were wobbling. All that happened. But eventually, ever since that day, Lakshman sir has taught me every single item, every single adabha class, every single item that I can think of. I think I've been extremely blessed in that, you know, my school would get over fairly late. So I would go to class also late, which means I would miss the regular adabha class. So he would sit separately and he would teach me. I think that is why I really got extremely fond of him, started talking to him, and he would tell me stories about Kalakshetra. Na Kalakshetra was both a cricket player. Na vandu inga irundha poda atta eppadi solluva. All that, you know, just used to go running around the seashore and in the footprints pannuvo, ambro waves will come and watch. And, you know, all that. So he would tell me all those fun stories. And appo, I never realized, you know, the importance of knowing enna ivar edho kadha solrar. But it used to be, he used to put a lot of jokes into it. It used to be very humorous. So as a little girl, you were so enamored by the whole thing. And I would just sit and just listen on, you know, not dance became secondary, listening to his stories and, you know, how he learned and all that became almost a part of dance class. And it was not just academics. Dance class was, you know, a parallel. I've always given it as equal importance. And I think the reason for that is because of Lakshman sir.
And slowly when I started doing items, then Manika would come and she would sit with me and Perena first all that she would ask. And then Lakshman sir said, oh, Avala, Avavanth Preeta, Avavanth Nanna Adu, and you know, I would say. So then with Manika, it was very different. You know, it was like you could talk to your mom. With your mom, you tell her everything. Like, mm-hmm. oh, this happened in school, that happened in school. So Manika in dance class for me was like that. So she was like, Priya, it'll be fine. Don't worry about it. Project, don't worry. The mudichittam, you can go in. So it was like, you know, you went there and you could actually cry out, you know, whatever you wanted to tell all your, I did very well. I got first rank. I got this. Everything she knew. So if Lakshman sir was that, you know, respectable father figure, she was the mother behind the whole thing. And if I would always go to Lakshman sir and ask him things. And not many, you know, students of his can take, you know, pride in the fact that, I know, I went and asked him myself. Because a lot of us were extremely scared. You know, he was very short-tempered. Adnala vandhi, not many people will have the courage to actually go and say, Lakshman sir, in fun. I don't know why that was. Maybe because, you know, he was always taking classes for me. I became very fond. And I would say, enna sir, idu kuda I can't do. And the, you know, I was very jovial. I would go and talk to him. And he would also reply back in the same way. So that fondness grew over the years. And if in spite of all this, if there was something that I could not tell him directly, then I would tell Manika, I would say, sir, to solidrela. She'll say, go and ask. You go and ask. But or it'll be something like, I want to learn Manavi Varnam. Because you know, he would say, you just now learnt another Varnam. Why do you want to learn the second Varnam? No, you go practice that. That is what that was his thing. Until you attain perfection in one thing, you should not go on to the next. That was always the thought process. But for me, you know, you're little, so you want to learn more. You want to, and it would be on the summer months where April and May was, we literally lived in the dance class. I would eat upma there, coffee, anything, bonvita, whatever was there. And we would dance. We would start around 8 o'clock in the morning, finish by 1:30, something like that. Starting from first tattad villarne, we will go on till varnam, padam, whatever, you know. And we had to do everything. There was no sitting down, resting alone. We started from A and finished to Z, then only we came home. And we were happy doing it. It was not like, oh, I've got to go to dance class. It was like, yay, I have to go to dance class. That was the, you know, the jubilation with which we went. And we were rewarded very well, because he would be so nice to us. He would tell us, you know, jovial stories, and he would say, Atta eppome idu solluva, Atta said that, Padmasini teacher said this, you know, like that. So he would relate. Let's say you're doing a particular item and you don't understand some story. Then he'll go back and he used to tell us the story. Krishnar vandhi idellam panninar. These were the pranks that he did. He actually took a pebble and he threw it. Yad eppadi pannuva? How will you do that? So you're thinking, you know, how you would do. So you've almost become Krishna. So he made sure that we, you know, understood the, not just the item, dance item was, you know, it was there, but, you know, the surrounding things, the paraphernalia around it also was important. In other words, the raga, the tala, the learning the sholikattu for a particular, you know, tillana or varnam, and also understanding the meaning. And depending on your age, he would, you know, alter the abhinayam and the shringara rasam, and he would say, nee adalam pannada, you're too young to do that, you don't do all that. Because he would go and see, you know, Kalanidhi mami or somebody doing it, and we would want to do the same thing, but he said, nee adalam pannada, it is not in your caliber, so don't do it yet. You can do it, not yet, he will say. So he gave us, you know, that sieve, and he knew edu panna will be aesthetic on stage for a dancer of this age. And that was very important. Dance class attire was extremely important. There was no way you could, you know, go in school uniform and just do it like that. There was no way. You had to change into your sari, you had to wear a single plait, and I had to wear two plaits for school. So what I used to do, I used to, you know, tie it right in the middle. So he would tell me, he would see in me, I don't know how, he is extremely observant in the class. And he'll know, and especially if it's me, he'll catch me, you know, and tell me, don't do it. It is discipline. I'm teaching you discipline, so don't, you know, go past it. So he would say, school when they ask you to do two plaits, you're able to do, right? Only in dance class, you cannot. When he asked that, it really struck me. He said, I know, I should not. That is an institution and there is a certain discipline and you adhere to it, right? So why wouldn't you want to do the same thing in dance class too? So that day, since then, it has always been single plaid for dance class. So it's a very small thing, you know, wearing a single plaid to dance class is a very small aspect of going to class. But it brings in, it inculcates the discipline in you, saying you have to do this a particular way. And that is what takes you to that end of perfection, that pinnacle of perfection, and that panache of finesse, that is what it gives you. And I'm so fortunate to have been with him for all those years that I was with him in class.
Wonderful. So
these are just some growing up memories that, you know, I remember distinctly. And he would always, you know, distinguish between dancers in the sense that you can teach this padam to her. Idu avalukku venda, he will say. He was very, you know, clear. You know, if you're not able to perform to the level that he wants you to, he will not teach you. That was the thinking in those days. Manyaka was very, very similar. The nice thing about Manyaka was, Manyaka, please teach me, no, teach me. So what she was so versatile in what she was doing, she will slightly change the hands. And then she will tell, Lakshmana, na vandha adha maathine, ena avadhu panna seriya irukadhu. And nee edhukku maathine, he will ask. He doesn't like any part of the composition being changed for any reason. And if she should have made a very slight, you know, change. Like, for example, instead of, you know, doing something like that, she would say, just come. She would have just changed it. He will say, adedika maathine, why did you change it? And, you know, it'll be between them. It'll be a very small change. It won't even be noticeable. Instead of doing this, you're just, you know, calling the person. But even that is, it's a huge difference for, like, at least what Lakshman sir was done. He's like, onak solli kudutha madri appadiye pannanum. Onnu maatha kudade, onnu change panna kudade. And the sequence eppadi irukko appadiye dhaan pannanum. Eduvume maatha kudade. This is Kalakshetra. That is what we were taught in Kalakshetra. You should not change that. Lakshman sir oda student na in the item edda ipdi dhaan irukkanum nu irukku. Adinala adha maatha kudade. And so some of my very, very fond memories of Manyaka go back to choreographing the Kadana Kudukula Tillana. This was a Balamurli Krishna composition, and she had heard it somewhere. It was a very recent composition. So, and she said, idhula vandu Krishna irukku, Radha irukku, ellame irukku. It's a very pretty, you know, the sahityam is extremely nice. Abdina, she was singing it. She was just humming it in class one day. I said, Manyaka, idenna pudhu thillana nee edha panna porela? I asked. So she said, no, this, I just heard the song. Adukulla nee kavanam kaadhil correct-a vilundudutha, she asked. So I said, Dilaka, idu panla, it sounds really nice. I'll do it for my program. And we'll sit and choreograph. So then the main classes were all occupied. So there was a new class which was all the way to the back, and it was only the cement floor, it was open to the sky. That is where we first started choreographing the Kadana Kudukula Tillana for the first time. Sometime must have been 85, 86, around that time. I must have been 10th, 11th, 12th, something like that. So in and around that time frame, I don't know the exact year, but I'm, you know, putting it between 85 and 87 is what it is. So, you know, she started choreographing and then, you know, I would do, she would say, idu panna, adu panna. So, you know, immediately we would do, and then the May adverse and everything, slowly it started getting, from infancy, it started getting some form. Mm-hmm. And in the middle, when the Lakshman sir will come, enna, what are you doing? Show me, abdina. So in the first, in the first May adverse, what we had changed was, it was all shikaram. The first was entirely shikaram. So sir came and said, இது இவ்வளவு விதவா இருக்குது, கொஞ்சம் மெல்லனமா இருக்கட்டுமே, எல்லா கட்டகா முகமும் அலப்பதுமோ மாத்திடும் சித்தி சார். So if you notice, everything, most of the choreography initially will all be Katakamukam, from Katakamukam to Alapadmam, Alapadmam to Katakamukam, or just Alapadmam. So it brought then that, you know, that femininity of the whole composition came out. And then Manika Sarama, it looks really pretty also. Very aesthetic. It's a very graceful choreography, that one. And then we finally finished the entire, Tillana was all complete. And then I had to do it in front of Lakshman sir. I was extremely nervous. I cannot tell you how nervous I was, because if he says, or you have to change it or something like that, we are starting from scratch. And my program was, you know, maybe in the coming week or something like that. And I still had to practice. I was still, you know, getting the second part of the Varnam. I was learning that. Plus, alongside this Tillana also. So it was too many things to, you know, coordinate and present and all of that. But luckily, all went off very well. And, you know, the Tillana is a great success. Till date, it's one of my favorite Tillanas, because I was so involved in, you know, the entire composition and the choreography and all that. So it was an extremely nice experience. But Manika, I think, is the most versatile person one can ever see. She was a mother figure in the class. You could go tell her anything. And, you know, sometimes we'll have programs in the temple and the Madrila we will have. So, you know, if you say, Manika, innala varamudiyadu, I won't go and tell sir. I will only go tell Manika. You know, there are things that we could only relate to her and she would understand. And then she will say, Preeta vandu varalanu solra, you know, and then sir, sari, okay, he would say, you know, so there are things that we could tell her and she would understand immediately. So that behavior and the whole molding that happened in dance class, it took us out into the world as, I think, very valuable citizens, I would say, because we learned not just to be dancers. We learned morals, we learned good ethics, and we learned how to be nice to others. The art is a very, it's a very dominant field, in the sense that, you know, people can get carried away with jealousy, and there are a lot of other things. You don't want to see the other dancers come up. So there is a lot of, you know, this goes on, and it's in the art field is like that. There is no, you know, you can't say two ways about it. But Lakshman sir, that way, was so different. He was so full of integrity. And, you know, Maniaka and Gopiyanna and Savitriyaka, who taught us Adavus, the entire, that guru, you know, parampara, I would say, of Bharata Chudamani, I think I would stand today and I'll just have to keep applauding. I wouldn't stop. So we learned so much from all of them. Without Gopiyanna, I don't think I've ever done a program. He's attended all kacharikko arda vasuka. And if he was not in town, only then we would, you know, think of an alternate. Otherwise, it is always Gopiyanna. Only if Maniaka was, you know, going to Bangalore for something, because, you know, Anna was going or something, appoda we would, Maniaka neenga irukka mattena, neenga rendu naal kaichukonga program kaichukonga, because, you know, you so want her there. And Ramu sir was he was just a pillar of strength when it came to, you know, practice sessions. And because Ramu sir will tell you to the face, he was very honest. He'll say, adha appadi pannada, that's it. You know, there is no, you cannot say, Ramu sir, idu ipdi pa kadaiyadu, ipdi dhaan pannanum. You know, so things like that, he would, you know, very categorically tell you this is the right way, there is a wrong way. There is no, you know, via media. So I actually had a name for him. I would even call him Yudhishthira because he was the eldest brother, right? So we would all call him Nejamave Rama. Such a personification of, you know, he was so calm, so composed, and, you know, very quiet person, but very stable. He knew what the difference between right or wrong. There was no gray area, not even in dance, not in art, not in life, not in anything. And he never took no for an answer. There was always, why should you not do it? He never took no for an answer. Ramasar, இது எப்படி பண்றது நீங்களும் இல்ல லக்ஷ்மண் சார் பண்ணலாம் ஏதாவது பண்ணிடலாம் டோன்ட் வரி. So this way that entire family, we grew up as a family, and it became important for later because you realize, you know, the values that you carry along with it, that, you know, you can't let down your dance class. You can't forget your roots that you came from. You would go and see other performers of different styles. I mean, we would go and see Varuvu Ramaya Pillaiyudaiya, you know, their sishyas who did dance. We would go and see Dhanayada Pani Pillaiyudaiya dancers who went and danced. Swami Vandale, Rajaratnam Pillai sir, we would go and see everybody's. But it's Kalakshetra, that is it. That style of Kalakshetra, we will not, those lines, those geometric angles, the way that we look, the way we see, you know, our smile, there are certain characteristics of Kalakshetra, and that we would never give up. We would never, you know, give it up for anything else. And that was really imprinted in our minds. You cannot say, no, I'll change it just a little bit, just so, you know, because I'm not able to sit in harmony. I came back to dance after about 25 years after I moved to the US. Mm-hmm. So Anga, it was very difficult because, you know, first I was, you know, studying, and then I had a career, and then family, and I mean, it all took its own time. Mm-hmm. But dance was something that was always close to my heart because it brought you close to your soul. So when I came back, I said, this is something I'm definitely going to do because it's always been a passion. So that's the main reason why we did the Kuruvanji in December last year as a tribute to him. And the first time that I danced was in the Bhatta Chudamani in Kalakshetra when Indu did the entire performance on August 3rd. It was so nice to see Manyaka sing, and, you know, it was just nice to see her on stage. And I never thought that would be the last performance that I would see her at that point of time. Mm-hmm. I think God is great. He's really blessed us with all of her compositions and her choreographies and her melodious voice. My entire DVD is full of her voice. So if I miss her, I just put on the DVD and Manyaka is right there with me. Lakshman sir's, you know, his Cholikattu and Gopiyanna's Mridangam and Ram sir's singing, it'll always be there as not just as fond memories, but it'll always be close to our heart as students of Bhakti Chudamani. I hope that answers quite a few of what you asked.
Ma'am, so you spoke about how you got back to dance after 25 years, and that's when you realized that, you know, dance was your passion and it would be your life.
Yes.
So was it propelled by a few incidents that you had with Manyaka and Lakshman sir during your learning days?
It was never, I'm going to a dance class. Dance class was a routine. It was a way of life. It was like how you went to school. If you go to school, you cannot tell anybody, are you going to school? Illa, I'm not going to school. Everybody goes to school nowadays, at least. It was the same those days too. So for me, dance class was, okay, my second school is dance class. That is how it was. It was so much a part of life that if I didn't go, I was missing out on something. So that is how much it affected me when I stopped dancing, basically. So I think that it was just piling up in me. Mm-hmm. And I think one of the first people that I went and told that I'm going to start dancing was Savitri Akka. Savitri Akka was my adabu guru. She taught me everything that was there about adabus. While Lakshman sir initially took all my adabu classes, he then, once Savitri Akka started coming, in the evening she would come for adabu class. Then Lakshman sir said, "Iva vandu Preetha nu pere, avalukku adabu suddham la nee dhaan pannanum." And he just, you know, handed me over to her. And she, you know, whipped a rod. She, you know, didn't spare anything. She didn't care how old I was, whether I was sweating, feet were hurting, aramandi could not be done. She didn't care. The pannano, that is Kala Kshetra style, you have to do it like that. Adu patti kala madakida eduthu vekkano, she would say. And when you sit, you know, when you do, one of the first things that I learned from her, where I saw a difference, was in the seventh natadam. You know, how she would go, apri paakano. You know, when you kila paathuta, apri paakano. You have to go up and then look. I've never heard anybody tell me all that before. Nobody has said, okay, you look at the hand and then you look. Nobody has told me all that. So, you know, the nuances of adabus, I learned from her. And unfortunately, if I don't do it like that now, I feel like I'm not dancing. So the first person I had to go and tell her, that I was coming back to dance was her. So I went to her place and I told her, and she goes, "Melila Varadu," she goes, she said, "It was so much within you that it's now just coming out," she said. I don't know what else to say, because that is exactly what happened. It was, you know, a volcano waiting to erupt, and it just did. And she said, "I don't know how you were able to do it all these years, but it's so good to have you back." And I told her, I said, "Savitri Akka, I'm really having one big problem in my practice." So she said, "Enna?" So I said, "You remember this Natadav and all that you've taught me? I used to be able to really do it well those days because I was young. You know, I could turn around, you could sit, and your circle adav and your mandi adav and all that, it was easy." I said, "I'm not able to do all that, especially because it's been 25 years. So she said, "Pannindeer, don't stop." That was her thing. So it didn't matter how old you are. That is what she was telling me. You can still do it with that passion in you, with that urge. And if you, with perseverance and with dedication, with a lot of hard work, it is not just yesterday, today, tomorrow, but it has to be done continuously. Otherwise, you will not see the results that you would want to. Maybe I will see the results, but for the gurus to look at me from above, I would want to do it a certain way. And when you want to reach that sort of a perfection, and you aim at that, you might not be the same, but you certainly aim for it. And I think with practice, it will come. It's not going away anywhere. So, you know, again, Savitri Akka was, again, a great help even now. Even when I was practicing last year, a few things, you know, I went and showed her. I played the music and I showed her, and she said, "Do it like this, do it like that. Kai ipdi pannu, kaal ipdi, kai ipdi paaru, namma ipdi dhaan pannuvom. Tripudakam, go at the tripudakam." And just little things like that. But it took me a long way into doing the program really well. I remember the first time that I did the Varuna Prakuravanji was in Natyanchali in 1985. I was in 10th standard, and the exams were supposed to be sometime April, around that time, because it used to be in April. Now it is in March, right? So Natyanjali is always during February, March. So, and this was a dance drama, which means all of us have to practice together to do the performance. And so initially Manyaka said, let her do the heroine role of Suratha Mohini. So that way, you know, she can even practice on her own. So that way she can practice. And only in the combined sessions, let her come and then she can practice. So she almost taught me about half of the Suratha Mohini Ode, all the parts, all the songs and the lyrics, Kai, Abhinayam, everything she had taught. So one day I was practicing with her and then Lakshman sir came inside. Enna pandra, what is she doing now? Yeah. So Manyaka said, illa, Suratha Mohini pannalam nenachen, so let her play Suratha Mohini. Yaar ivala? அவளை பார்த்தா சுருத்த மோகினி மாதிரி இல்ல, அவ மூஞ்சிப்பா என்ன நாட்டியா இருக்கு பாரு, கொரத்தி பண்ணட்டும், அதுதான் அவளுக்கு அம்ஸ், கரெக்டா அதுதான் இருக்கும். She will do well only as கொரத்தி அப்படி. So I was bent upon even last year to do the கொரத்தி. I told people I don't want to do the heroine role. And I was very fortunate because Uma Murli was she was a very, very, very good friend of mine. She initially said, Deepa, I don't think I can do it and all of that. I forced her. I said, you are doing this for Lakshman sir. And I forced her. I said, you have to do the heroine. And I will be the Kurati. The chemistry is going to be great. That is what we wanted to do. And for me, it was more like, this is what Lakshman sir would have wanted. This is what Manyaka would have wanted. So when I called Manyaka and told her, namba Varna Prakarvanchi Pandra Manyaka, Nidane Korthi Pandra, she asked. Because she knew what had happened the last time. She said, Nidane Korthi Pandra, Ani Korthi Pandra, Uma Pandra, Uma will be great for, you know, Suratha Mohini. So what I'm trying to say is, even though, you know, we are all senior dancers or we consider ourselves to know dance enough that we can make our own decisions. But no, we didn't do that. The first person I called was, I called Manyaka and I said, Manyaka, idu pannalam irukko, na vandu korthi idu pannatama, is what I asked. Is it okay if I do? And Manyaka, immediately she says, nee korthi dane pandra. She, you know, that was her rebuttal. And then I said, Uma is there. Uma pannatoka, is it okay if Uma does the Suratha? Uma ye pannatom. So, we are so used to that asking, you know, if it's going to be okay. It's not like, oh, I know what it is. I'm going to do it on my own. That is not how we were brought up. In this day and age, we don't see that too often. But because of what we were taught, you know, while we were in dance class, that thought process didn't go. You know, immediately I would call and ask, and Manyaka would say, Sari, who's going to sing? Gopiya Vasikitam. She would say, and you know, she basically just did the whole thing, like how she would do in class. Oh, program, in the items, panla, ivar vandu flute vasipar, gopi vandu maradam vasipar, sir, eppadi irukar, Lakshman anna irupar, Ram anna vena first paadukam, na padam paadur. They would always, they knew how to go about, the entire program was all set. So there was no confusion as far as, you know, who's going to do what. There was nothing. Items were decided. And, then it was always up to us to go and practice that. Then it was up to the dancer to perform to the level that they expected us to do. So the same thing came last year also. I started practicing sometime in February for the December program. Mm-hmm. And Uma once asked me, she said, she called for something else and I said, Uma, I'll call you in about half an hour and just practice. She said, it's only February and you're practicing. It's March. You're still already practicing. I said, Uma, I've been out of this for about 25 years. She was, you know, she practices every day. So, and for me to perform, you know, to in par with everybody, I thought it would take a really, really long time. I think God was extremely kind to me. We really did a great performance. Everybody, they very, very much appreciated what we did. And we got very, very extremely good raving reviews also. The Rasikas really enjoyed because we had a full, you know, PPT of Sir's thing going throughout the entire performance. So that they said that was a very, you know, personal touch. And Savitrekha said, Erika, avara paaka paaka, I'm just getting tears in my eyes. And that's exactly what she said. So it brought back a lot of memories for a lot of people. We had Shantamani and Mami also came. And everybody was felicitated on stage. And the very nice thing was Sudhanani auntie had come and she spoke about Lakshmi sir in that program. It is one of the most memorable events in my life. I would even mark it. I would even call it a red letter day for me. So we had a lot of fun doing it. We had a lot of a lot of fun in the sense that, you know, when as dancers we felt like we were back in dance class. The only person missing was Lakshman sir initially, and Ramu sir's singing. But in the side, and then when we lost Maniyaka, it was a huge blow because we didn't know. We had lost a chariot. That's how we all felt, because then Uma even said, I don't think we should even be doing this, because we were so heartbroken. We didn't know, you know, how to recuperate and do this. So then, you know, we had a meeting, all of us met, and we said, you know, if we are doing this for Lakshman sir, so let us do it for Maniyaka also. At this point, it will be a tribute for her also. And I think she wouldn't ask for anything more. If we did this well, I think she'll rest in peace, and you know, she'll find peace and tranquil in his lotus feet. So that got us to where we were. That was Ilana. I don't think that program would have even gone through. It would have been a total disaster, so to speak, because it was like we lost the kingpin in the machine, and we didn't know what to do. We were looking here and there, but we had to collect ourselves and make it happen. So that took a lot of strength, and I think all the dancers who were there, Vidyashri, Uma, myself, Vidyashri's daughters, all of us, I think we really put in a lot of effort, especially from that October time frame, because then we knew, you know, we didn't have, it is not like Maniyaka is there and she'll say, oh, either change this, change that, you go behind, you come from. There was nobody to tell us, you know, so we were really stranded, but it went off very, very well. So I think that concluded last year. Mm-hmm. This year has been a little difficult on all of us because of Corona and all of that. So we'll have to see what pans out this year.
True. That's true. It's been like a great void that can't be replaced by anybody.
Yes. That's an understatement, I would say. I don't think her void can ever be filled, because those are very, very big shoes to fill. When we lost Lakshman sir, it was like a part of us was gone. You know, he just took it away when he went. And when Maniyaka is gone, then, you know, I was grieving for so long, but then I played the music and I said, okay, I have to get back to practice. That is the only way, you know, to find the strength in yourself, and that inner strength also, I think, came from them. I think it was a divine blessing from both of them that we were able to do what we did. Otherwise, I don't think it would have even been possible under the circumstances. So,
thank you so much for sharing all your experiences and moments of those precious moments, which I think we also relived with you those days, the golden period.
Yes, yes.
Thank you so much for sharing all those.
I think it was my period, my dance class days, I would just call it the golden age. That is what I would call it, because it's never coming back. And we just have to make it better. And to make it better, we need to devote ourselves 100%. We need that the same dedication that I had when I was 12 and 13. And the perseverance that sir has so beautifully inculcated in us. We didn't know that he was doing it, but the way that he has done it, I think we should really go in and, you know, draw the strength from there. And the tribute for Sir is something that I would personally like to dedicate this to him every year, in whatever little way possible. So I think Maniaka will, you know, she will enjoy that. She will revel in the tribute that we are placing for them this year. Mm-hmm. Very, very soon, you know, we'll probably come up with something and we'll let everybody know what is going on. But I really want to thank you, Saujanya. I think it's a great initiative that you and Naina are doing. You can only do, you know, so much, because there is so many words that are unsaid, so many incidents that you cannot even relate to. And there are so many episodes that happen, because we were in class every day, and every day something would happen. So it's difficult to, you know, come back and say, well, what is your most memorable moment? And I would just draw a blank, because for me, when we were sitting with Sir in practice, he told me once, this was when, you know, I would go late in the class, like I told you. So only I was, he was teaching me something and only I was in class. And he told me, he said, you always have to remember one thing when you're in a practice session in dance class. In dance class, in other words, you think that the audience is sitting in front of you, and how would you perform? You would give in your full 100%. That is what you should do when you're in dance class. And when you're in stage, what do? You think that you're in dance class and you're dancing before me.
Mm-hmm.
It brought a whole new perspective in the way that you look at things, and that is exactly what I did from then on. From the day that he told me, that is exactly what I've done. Because on stage, you're yourself. You're not inhibited, and your emotions just come. It just flows, mm-hmm. because you're one with the song. You think practice session, I'm with in front of Sir only. You know I'm doing. So it's a very different experience, and you're doing your full. You want to give it your 100%. When you're in dance class, you're thinking, oh, I'm performing before an audience. I better, you know, do a good job that the rasikas like what I do. So just for that emotion to come back, you would do it a certain way. So this correlation between the audience and Sir and me, this triangulate thing, really this triangular experience, so to speak, I think that brings in a whole new dimension to the share. I really, really want to thank both of you for doing this and giving me this wonderful opportunity to do my samarpanam to Maniaka. It's been an extreme honor, and it's been my hugest pleasure, I would say. So just want to thank you.
Our pleasure.
And thank Naina also.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thanks, Akka.
Thank you. Sri Gurubhyo Namaha.
Sri Gurubhyo Namaha.
Thank you, Dr. Preeta, for sharing your experiences. Our next item is on Raghavendra Swami, written by Jagannath Dasa. He was believed to be a Shalada, brother of Prahalada. He was an ardent devotee of Raghavendra Swami or Rayaru, and he was written scores of poems on Rayaru. He spoke regularly to Rayaru and visited Mantralaya often. Even today, when the doors of Raghavendra Swami Temple are about to be closed in the night, Thugire Rayara is sung before the Utsava Murti is placed back in the Sanctum Sanctorium. Thugire Rayara in Ragam Mohana, choreographed by Srimati Nagamani Srinivasara. This Devarmanama was one of Maniaka's favorite compositions. She choreographed this beautiful piece, and it was taught to Bharatadarshana students by her daughter-in-law, Srimati Saujanya Madhusudan. perfectly apt to be featured in our Shishyakulam series, as different generations of teachers have passed on this beautiful arrangement. Our performers today are Akshara and Smriti from Georgia, Mansa and Shruti from Ohio, Aditi, Dhriti, and Vaishnavi from Texas.
Tu ke re yogindra, kar kamal puja tu.
Thank you, girls. Next, we have Srimati Padmini Chari, who is a senior student of Sri Adiyar K. Lakshman. She was trained by Srimati Nagmani Srinivasa Rao and Sri Adiyar K. Ramarao as well. She is the director of Nritya School of Dance in Houston, Texas.
Namaskaram. Smaran Arpanam, an artistic tribute to Maniyakka, our guru and founder of Bharata Darshana, late Srimati Nagamani Srinivasa Rao. Smaran Arpanam is a 10-day global online dance and music festival from 10th October, which marks 1 year since our beloved Maniyakka left for the heavenly abode, to 20th October, which marks Bharata Darshana's 32nd anniversary. This festival brings to you more than 150 dancers and musicians from all over the globe. We invite you to witness an exciting lineup of theme-based events, Mani Nritya Malika, Guru Parampara, Shishya Kulam, and Bhava Pravaham. We welcome you to Bhava Pravaham, interview series with family members, artists, and senior students of Maniyakka. Today we have with us Guru Srimati Padmini Chari, a senior disciple of Guru Padmashri Adiyar K. Lakshman, Guru Srimati Nagamani Srinivasa Rao, and Padma Bhushan Guru Srimati Kalanidhi Narayan. She is the founder director of Nritya School of Dance in Houston and has been teaching Bharatanatyam for 37 years. I now request our director, Guru Srimati Saujanya Madhusudan, daughter-in-law of Maniyakka, to host the session. Saujanya ma'am, over to you.
Thank you, Vandana. Namaskaram, Padmini aunty.
Namaskaram.
It's a pleasure to have you with us today as part of the Bhava Pravaham series, and thank you for sparing your precious time with us to share your memories and experiences of the moments spent with Maniyakka. Aunty, when was the first time you met Amma, and what can you recollect for us from that moments?
Yeah, I met, as we call her affectionately, Maniyakka, I think in 1976, I met her. So I started actually also training from her from that year. So when I used to go to Lakshman sir's house, and Lakshman sir would teach, but then we always spent more time with Maniyakka, and we just established that relationship between us. I think later on we became more friends than the guru and the Sishya. We became very good friends and we could connect. And I was very comfortable learning from her, because I used to be scared of Lakshman sir, but then she had so much of patience to teach any sequence and make us write down. I think it was so lovely and so comfortable learning from her. And she has been a very, very big part of my dance training. I have to say this because she has not only taught me, she has composed a lot of dances for my productions. And practically for every recording since 1977, she has given vocal support. So that involves so much of practice. Before, it was not like now that each one would come and sing or that play the mridangam in a different channel and go back. There is no interaction. So if it's a recording, we spent like almost like from morning to evening in the recording studio. So you can imagine the connection we all developed. You know, I'm talking about Maniaka was my main vocal support for all the recordings. Maniaka and I don't know, Saujanya, if you know, Veena Kandan, Unnikrishnan sir, the flute, and Gopi, and the mridangam. And so these are all the familial people. I mean, these are the people who have done all my recordings for that many years. You know, I mean, every year I go, music was not that accessible to us before. I mean, we all had to have a custom recording. So Manika has helped me so much in this, either giving me practice. I mean, before the recording, we need to practice the whole production and then somebody has to dance there too. And so she has done so much help, so much she has done for me, either in her house, I used to go to her house, or she used to come to my house, or we did in Lakshman sir's house, you know. So that's why, I mean, she did so much and I feel sometimes more credit should have been given to her at that time, but she was a very humble a person who just did not ask for praise or anything. And she loved what she did and she cared for all the students she taught. So I don't know, so almost every day I used to learn from her something, and she helped me compose a lot of dances in the production Krishnanjali, which I did, and that Varuna Purukuruvanji, the famous choreography work of Sir Lakshman sir, she's the one who taught me the whole dance drama, and she's the one who recorded the whole thing, charge and recorded the whole thing for me, which was a big project those days. And then again for I think Shakti, one other production, she was the one, she took charge of everything. I learned from Lakshman sir, but when there was a recording or anything, she took complete charge of everything and did everything for me. I am so grateful to her because I could not have done without Maniaka. In my days, I learned from Lakshman sir at Bharata Chudamani in Gandhinagar. That's and awesome. Of course, continued this when they moved. And it's not just in a personal way, also I interacted with Maniaka so much, such a loving and caring person. And is always ready to help when I need any ideas or forgotten items. She was always very helpful. Even when she moved to Bangalore, when I came to Bangalore to visit my brother, I always used to call her. The best thing was I talked with her a few days before she passed away. This was Vijayadashmi, I think, Saujanya. It was like a few days.
The day after Vijayadashmi is when she passed on.
Yeah. And I asked her for her blessings and she replied to me. And that's why it came such a shock to me when a few days afterwards this happened, you know. So that was the saddest day because I did talk to her a few days before on Vijayadashmi Day. So she's been a big part of my life. And I'm so grateful to her for, I owe her so much for all my production, for all my recordings and all the teachings and the training she has given me with so much of patience and caring.
That's wonderful, Akka. When you think of Maniaka, what comes to your mind first?
The first thing, I mean, she's an excellent guru, okay? And very ever helpful. She has also conducted 3 arangetrams of my students in India. And she's a very, very hardworking person who so fully puts her heart and soul in her work. And this is what she's done for all the 3 arangetram students who went from here to have arangetram there. She was the one who fine-tuned them and still sang for them during the Arangetram. So I'm so grateful. For me, the first thing which comes to us is a wonderful guru, you know.
Mm-hmm.
A wonderful guru, a wonderful choreographer, which yeah. I have experienced with her.
That's very true, Nanti. It's very like, I can just go with you.
She's so gentle and so patient with me. I mean, in the initial stages. So, you know, it's just that made me so comfortable going with her. I could pick up the phone and call her anytime. She's always willing to help.
Mm-hmm.
Always willing to help. And I remember in between also, she got very sick at that one time, I think a few months. She was very sick. I was in constant contact with her and I was so happy.
Mm-hmm.
She became better and started resuming her normal classes and all that. And suddenly this, you know, so yeah, like I told you, this she has been an important part in Adya Lakshmi's class. Yes, she has been a very important part in my training. So this is so many years I've trained with her. And every time summer I go, I contact her and she always was willing to teach me, compose dances for me and give me ideas. So many, she's composed a lot of dances for me for my production.
Mm-hmm. So, Aunty, when you say that she has composed a lot of dances, we know so many of her choreographies, which are so famous. And what is it that style and choreography that you would really see that is different from others, or what are those special touches that she would give in her choreographies, or the style of teaching that you have experienced as a dancer?
Yeah, so of course I've learned Lakshman's first item and her items. I like, you know, she has composed Kadana Kutuhalam Tillana. Then she did a lot of individual pieces. Like, I don't think anybody's even seen those pieces. Meenakshi Pillai Tamil, she has done, it got lost after the production, you know. So I like, I mean, the way she did that choreography, the very flowing way. I liked it very much, you know, because when I first, and she has, I think you must be knowing the Mallari also, which she composed. So a lot of high tech. Yeah. And so it's the style was the same, like Lakshman sir's. I mean, the Kalachitra style doesn't go away at all. But she had this different way to flow the adavus, the sequence of the jatis and all that. So I found it very fascinating to learn something different in the same class, and both of them had a different touch to it. So, and she has done, and a lot of padams also I learned from her, you know. Before I went to Mami's, a lot of padams I learned from her. So I liked all her compositions, and that's why I used to give some lyrics to her and then she would compose for me, you know. So it was a very nice experience working with her as she was composing. So that's a very interesting part of it, when I could sit with her and then she would give me ideas and we could sort of interact and exchange ideas. And she gave me that freedom, you know. She didn't say, oh, you have to do it this way. You know, if there's any other way, she was very open to ideas, you know. I'm sure you all must have realized she's very, very open to ideas. And she could take back the ideas and then put it in different way in movements. So she always gave us a scope to bring out our creativity and individuality. And that I really admire in Maniaka, you know. She was never rigid and say, no, this is all you have to do. And usually Lakshman sir would always ask students to learn from Maniaka whenever it comes to the Kaiyi, as they say, all the Abhinaya part of it. You know, he would teach the sequences, Jatis, Tirmanas, but always send us to Maniaka for the Abhinaya part of it, you know. So that's where I got to know how she composes and how much freedom and scope she gave us to do our own thing and then show her, you know. So yeah, that was a very good experience. Even a lot of varnams, like Mohamana, most of the varnams we have learned hands from Maniaka only. The Abhinaya part we learned from Maniaka.
That's interesting.
And, sir, like only to teach the Tirmanams.
Yeah. Auntie, as a dancer, not as a dancer, just but even as a person, how do you think the acquaintance with them, the association with Lakshman sir and Maniyaka molded you as a person or as a dancer? What was the best part of that time period when you were?
I really owe everything to them. Everything I do now, what I am, I owe it to them. Because first of all, the discipline they taught me. The discipline in life, the discipline, the moment I stepped in Lakshman sir's house, the way he taught me, and also Saujanya, I spent like almost 16 years, every year he used to come and stay with me for 1 month, Lakshman sir, almost a month. And every day I learned something from him. It's almost like, you know, he has just guided my life, the discipline I have and what I have to teach and stick to the rules, the tradition. And same with Maniyaka, we were part of the family there, Saujanya. I mean, it's not like I came, went to the class and came back and all the Krishna, Baba, they Indu were all very, very young at that time. So I spent like half my day there. You know, I used to go home only at 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock. So it's just sitting with them and talking. I learned so much, so much from them. It's, and then when he came here, of course, Lakshman sir, when he came here, every day in the night, he used to talk to me. I learned so much from them. And I feel I cannot do without them. They are part of my life. Whether I teach, whether I go about in my life, they are part of, when I dance, they are part of my life. Always they will be. This is something I just hold so dear to my heart. My gurus, without that, I'm not here where I am now. This is everything done by them. This is very sincerely, it's come out of my heart. I'm telling you, this is without them, it's just, I'm not here. It's just, I would not have been the person I am now. I mean, especially the humility they taught me, you know. Mm-hmm. They're all so great, but they never praised. They never said, I knew everything. Lakshman sir always used to say, oh, I don't know anything at all. I mean, that he gave the students, like, just don't be arrogant with the art, you know, just be humble with your art. And that I have learned from him. Just, I do not know anything or everything at all. There's so much to learn. That's what he kept saying. There's so much to learn. I know still there's so much to learn, but it always keeps learning. I'm hoping that I can pass this on to my students, you know. Whatever he has taught me, I try to pass it on. He always used to say, you have to listen to stories of great dancers and great teachers and learn so much from them. So I try to talk about my teachers to my students so they will imbibe something of this, you know. Even though the present generation is very different, but there are some who listen to it and they are able to get a little bit of what I've gone through. That's it. So it's just
What are the few incidents that you spent with Maniyaka and Lakshman sir that made you decide that dance should stay with you forever? A couple of incidents that you can.
I will say it is during the initial years. You know, I mean, there's not just dance because I had so much fun with them also. I mean, this is the informal moments we had. I mean, it was so much fun. I mean, you know how the artists, when they get together, like the mridangam player, I mean, it's entirely a different scenario before. You know, they used to joke, they used to laugh. They had so much fun that I could not do without that at all. You know, I had to make it a part of my life. I mean, the dedication I got is just after 76, when I went there, I just never wanted to stop. Mm-hmm. They are so much, influenced me in their thinking, the way they talk, the way they taught. Everything influenced me. And when I say this, this really comes from my heart, you know. These are the people who have made my life, made who I am now.
That's really like, they've played a really important role in our lives to what we even see ஒரு தட்டெடுப்பு பண்ணா கூட இட்ஸ் தெம் ஹூ லைக்
எஸ் எஸ் எக்ஸாக்ட்லி யூ நோ
எவ்ரிதிங் ஐ ரிமெம்பர் அம்மா லைக் நான் தித் தித் டைப் பண்றச்ச அந்த தி சி டைப் பண்ணாத தித் தித் டைப் பண்ணு
எஸ் ஐ நோ ஐ நோ ஐ மீன் தீஸ் ஆர் தி ஸ்மால் திங்ஸ் தட்ஸ் வாட் ஐ அம் சேயிங் யூ நோ ஐ மீன் ஷி வுட் சீ தி ஸ்மால் திங்ஸ் அண்ட் கரெக்ட் விச் இஸ் சோ யூஸ்ஃபுல் யூ மைட் நாட் சீ இட் ஆன் ஸ்டேஜ் பட் தென் வென் யூ டு தி கரெக்ட் வெர்ஷன் ஆஃப் இட் யூ கேன் ஃபீல் இட்
True.
So those are the corrections. Oh yeah, I love to be corrected by them because that's why I want to go to class, do all the basic steps. That's what, wherever the basic steps is going on, I'll go there, you know, because that's what I wanted, all the corrections, how to do it. So whichever room has basic steps going on, that's where I will go. I'm talking about 70s and 80s. Whenever I go for holidays to India, I always used to go and do this. Yeah. And they were always welcome. They never said, oh, you have class from 7 to 8, you know, you have to go at 8. No, you can stay the whole day if you want and join any class you want and pick up whatever items they were teaching, you know, that freedom we had. So I never used to leave the class until my parents called me and said, you have to come home now, you know. So I really enjoyed the time with them so much. That I am so glad I was with them all these years. It's really helped me and I really miss them, you know. There's no doubt about it. I miss them so much. The same thing Lakshman sir also, I talked with him 2 days before he left us, you know. So I used to call them frequently and talk to them also. All that I miss now. So, but they are there. I think of them every day.
I clearly remember whenever we used to talk to Lakshmama, we used to call him and talk to him. He would always ask, ella dance la epdi pandre, all those things would go on. And then he would say, Padmini ki hi solid. That he would always, that would be a part of the course. He would never...
About like 25 letters he wrote. He used to write patiently, he will write. Mm-hmm. You know, pages and pages of what he is doing, what students conducted Arangetram, who are all dancing, who came to class. I have so many of my letters. And I also was telling, I have probably, he didn't have time later on because every song I have in the practice tape, each sequence, each Tirumanam, at least 10 times he has recited. So I have all this with me. So whoever wants it, I will give a copy to them. So hopefully you can treasure it, you know.
Yes, sir. Yes, Auntie. So, that's what this whole attempt is to actually to collect all those memories that we all spent with them. And
I couldn't do it today, but I have him doing Rupamujuji. I have him doing Shankarabharanam Varnam. I have him, he did so many items. Just he would say, come and take a video, I feel like dancing. And then he would do the whole item. And I have all these videos. This is such a treasure, you know. And I'm just looking up all this and I said, no, I have to convert it digitally and give it to all his students, you know, and spread. That's what he always used to say. He never used to kept an item for himself. Mm-hmm. He said, my item should spread everywhere. All the students should learn my item. He never said, oh, this item belongs only to me or I'll teach it only to you. Everybody needs to learn his items. Mm-hmm. And Maniaka also was like that, you know. So they were so generous in giving, you know, so generous with their items. And everybody needs to learn that. So this is why I want to share all the treasure I have, all the Tirmanams of all the Varnams written in Tamil by himself. All this I have. So I want to pass it on now, you know. I've enjoyed it so many years. Now I want to give it. I'll definitely convert everything to digital and then,
please,
hand it over to you.
Yes, please. Whenever it is ready, we would want to create a library of all the works of Amma, Lakshman sir, and Rama Mama, and Gopi Mama, and keep them all. So that the next thing we know how great they were and what they left back for us, and this is what this whole attempt is, to do Smaranarpanam, not just to Amma, but coincidentally it happens to be there during this time, but it has always been in my mind that, okay, we have to do this as part of, for them, because Amma or Lachamama always used to like feel like this has to be given. Namma kaila onnume vechinda it will not help. It has to be passed on to everyone else. So, Adanale, please, I would be grateful to
yes,
you.
Yes, because a lot of items have got lost.
True. Amma kada. Yeah, nareya.
So, I have most of the items from the video. I used to also write down, so I have all the items. I can teach just from the notebook because I have written down everything. But I also have videos which I'll convert into CD flash drive and then send it to you. And most of Manika's items, everything I have, you know.
Mm-hmm. So, that's an amazing collection to have, and pass it on to the next generation who are who need to know how great their legends they were and yes. how giving they
That's
were,
what.
Caring they were. So that
I want to talk about my gurus and say how great they are. So they will, the students will get something out of this, you know, what it is to have a good guru, you know. So I love talking about them to my students. I do that all the time. And so I hope, you know, I could do, this is all least I can do. I want to collect all his works. And I probably, you're the best person to give this to. So, you know, you can preserve all this videos, so the, even all the notes, everything I have. And he's written by him, all the Tirmanams of all the Varnams. I mean, I was one of the fortunate students who learned most of his choreography, most of the items I've learned, yeah, except maybe one or two Varnams I've left. So everything I've learned. So everything I have in notebook and written by him, you know. So that's authentic, you know. Authentic. Nobody can say anything. It's just authentic. He used to come here and during the daytime, he used to do all this. Mm-hmm. Write down all the things. But Maniaka also has written all the songs. Whatever I've learned, she herself has written and given it to me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I couldn't write Tamil properly, so she would take each song and write it. She took this time to write down everything for me. And all this, it might be a little bit torn here and there, but I have all the notes with me, you know.
Yeah.
So love to share it with you. You know, I just give me some time. I will do all this and send it to you, you know, pictures, everything. Yeah.
Auntie and of course, Maniakka, Amma and Lachumama used to come to Houston and spend time for Arangetrams to spend time with you. And also, I'm sure you will have gone toured outside. Any few fond memories from those times that you would like to share with us?
Yeah, I think Lakshman sir has come more times, you know, than Maniaka. And I think you came once with Maniaka also to my house, right?
Remember no, I came with my sir? Parents.
No. Maniaka came once also with you. I have pictures.
That was the second time. First time it was my parents who came.
Yeah,
that was the first time.
Second time, Maniaka came. Yeah, you all came here, yeah, and then I was with you.
We had a nice lunch served, and we can never forget.
With Lakshmi, yes, we have gone on road trips. Oh my God, I can write a book on all this.
Sure, you must do that, Auntie.
Oh my God. Yeah. You know how humorous he is.
Yeah.
Oh my God, this is just so many incidents, you know, so many. We had so much fun. I don't know, I can write a book. I can't think of me, but this was every Arangetram was something would happen, you know. I think he conducted like about, 18 Arangetrams of my students.
Mm-hmm.
So he had come almost every year. And I can tell you stories about, you know, it was so much fun working with him, and you know that he's there, he will take charge of everything. So that comfort level I had. So he's going to take charge of everything. I don't have to stress myself out, you know. And so, yeah, he used to be part of the family here, you know. We never thought it was he was a guest here. Mm-hmm. Same thing with Maniaka and Lakshmi, never thought we were guests. We were just part of the family. And I had the freedom to do whatever they wanted to do in the house, and they felt comfortable also, you know. Yeah, so yeah, I'll write a book, Saujanya.
Sure, auntie, yes, please. I would love to have that. Any of Lachumama's or Amma's favorite choreography that you could share with us? Like, of course, Kadanam Kutuhalam Tillana, Mallari, you've spoken about it, and Varanapura Kuravanji, how you learn them. But what is the most, the one that's favorite to you? Like, you would always, it will always be dear to you.
Oh, the Lakshman sir is definitely the Kamaswarnam. Nithya Kalyani, of course, is all favorite.
Yes.
the way he taught me Kamaswarnam, each Thirvan was so difficult and made me do 10 times. I don't think I'll ever forget that Varnam in my life. Even though I learned it sometime in 81 or something, I don't think I'll forget it at all. Mm-hmm. And Maniaka has done a lot for me, you know, in productions. I don't know, you've not seen all that. If I have this, I'll send it to you. She did the Meenakshi Pillai Tamil. It came up so beautifully, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So very beautifully it came. And so I don't know, I hope I have a video. It's completely lost, the title. It's well, at that time, if you don't take a video, you don't have anything at all.
Yeah.
So I love that for the Shakti, she did that. And that's such a very lovely piece she did, which I loved it. If I find it, I will definitely send it to you.
Please. Please, auntie, yes.
And I think she's done, no, apart from Mallari and Tillana, she's done so many.
You're also doing 17th and 18th Manindritya Malika, which is all her choreography, all her students.
Oh, what are you all doing here?
All her choreographies, we have like more than two margams that are going to be lined up, and all the Satandar Arangetram and all, they're going to be performing on the 17th and the 18th. That is a theme for Navratri starting.
Yeah, please just give me the information so I can watch it.
So it's going to be on Facebook Live, yeah. Please do watch. And
yes, absolutely, absolutely.
A whole session, like festival pandramariye, 17th and 18th, planning to do that.
Okay, so you're also dancing?
I am dancing only on tomorrow as an inauguration, but the pro I have the administration and all that is a big thing. So
definitely I will watch it. Because if it's her work, I'm sure I can recognize a lot of it, you know.
So, new choreographies that she has done for Arangetrams and Pudusa Pannal, all those things are going to be presented. That is
okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, after, yeah, I'm sure she must have done it.
Marks 1 year.
Restarting.
Yeah, please just give me the information so I can watch it.
So it's going to be on Facebook Live.
Came last.
So some part of the Kamaswarnam that's so dear to you that you learned from them. And Oru Chinna line, something if you could just show it for us.
Oh my God.
Any padam, anything, any two hands, just for... if you're comfortable, otherwise it's okay. We'll take it. We'll get a video from you, sure.
If he's saying something, I'll do it. I don't want to sing and then, oh my God, no. I'm not a... it's nice, Sarjanya, to talk to you this long.
Yeah. Thanks for sharing all those wonderful moments.
God, I'm so happy. I mean, I know sometimes I feel so much, but I cannot
express in
words how much I appreciate my gurus and what they've done for me, how they changed my complete life. I'm always grateful to them, always. And I think of them every day.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Ani. Thanks for sharing.
Thank you. Thank you for having me and sharing.
Take care of yourself. And yes, hope everything goes well.
I hope so. Hopefully. Yeah. Yes. Thank you also. Thank you, both of you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, Padmini Auntie, for sharing your beautiful memories. Next, we bring to you Srimati Jyotismati Swaminathan and her daughter, Shreyasi Sundar. Srimati Jyotismati started her training in Kalakshetra style under the able tutelage of Guru Adiyar K. Lakshman and Srimati Nagmani Srinivasara. She picked dance back up after a long break with Srimati Saujanya Madhusudan. Both Shreyasi and Jyotismati are students of Bharata Darshana. Talk about generations. Mother learned from a guru whose niece-in-law is the daughter's guru. What better example will we find for Shishyakulam series?
Jyotishmati Swaminathan. This is my daughter, Shreyasi Sundaram. And we are students of Bharata Darshana for the past 5.5 years under the able tutelage of Srimati Saujanya Madhusudan. And we are extremely honored to be featured in the Shishyakulam series of Smaranarpanam, an artistic tribute to Mani Akka. And a few words. I started my training at Bharata Chutamani under Adyashri K. Lakshman sir, and Mani Akka used to teach there as well. And I'm extremely blessed to be able to continue that journey and started learning again with Srimati Saujanya at Bharata Darshana. And also blessed that I can have my daughter learn with her too. Some of the things that I see that Saujanya is doing to cultivate the art is how firm she is with the tradition of the art form itself, Bharatanatyam, and also how she adapts herself with the new technology, and also in this quick world of technology-driven life. She knows how to communicate with the kids, so they are also interested in learning the art form. And she's really awesome with the kids, and that's really important if we want to continue the Bharatanatyam tradition to the future generations. Shreyasi would like to say a few words about Saujanya and how she enjoys dance class with her.
Saujanya Auntie is a great teacher because she's patient and kind, but at the same time strict with us students learning the right way. I also love to dance because it has a rich history, and I would like to pass it down to future generations. I'm also very thankful to be part of Bharata Darshana to learn this ancient art of Bharatanatyam.
Thank you all. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. And now we would like to perform the Pushpanjali and Ganesha Shlokam for you. This is the first big item that I learned from Sri Lakshman sir. And I was so happy and thrilled when Shreyasi was ready to learn it from Saujanya as well. And extremely blessed to be performing along with Shreyasi today for Shishyakulam series of Smaranarpanam. Thank you.
The tight.
That was just beautiful, Jyotismati and Shreyasi. Thank you all for being tuned. We will continue to bring to you more of these beautiful memories, items in the days to come. Saujanyaka, do you have a few words?
Thank you. We extend our sincere thanks to Dr. Preeta Sampath, Srimati Padmini Chari, Srimati Jyotishmati Swaminathan and Shreyasi, and all the students of Bharatadarshana for sharing their wonderful memories of Maniyakka. I would like to thank my wonderful team of volunteers for their countless hours, days, weeks in preparing and finally getting to this point. Thank you to our viewers for your continued support.
Thank you, Saujanyaka. We will continue to bring to you live and pre-recorded events in the various themes, Bhava Pravaham, Shishyakulam, Guru Parampara, and Mani Nritya Malika. Stay tuned for more amazing memories. And we go live Saturday and Sunday with 2 sessions each featuring Mani Nritya Malika, beautiful gems choreographed by Srimati Nagmani Srinivasarao. Don't miss it. Good evening.
Shubharatri.